If you're struggling to overcome shyness, self-doubt, and timidity, and can't seem to make straight meaningful conversations with people or even meet new friends, what's the best book solution for your issue? Okay, I admit the most go-to book for having friends and influencing people is Dale Carnegie's book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. The title of this book is so epic, almost all the book lovers and smart people of the world bought it when it was first published. No wonder it is so popular. Although it is a classic book, yet it is my favorite piece on crushing timidity and building a better relationship with people. The first time I read the book, I was a very shy person, still in university. I could hardly make a conversation with anyone, let alone make new friends. I started to read this book one day, and the following day, I felt released and was literally walking up to strangers and engaging them in conversations. The book is indeed a must-read and should be in everyone's archive. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you some lessons I learned from reading the book. Subscribe to this channel so you don't miss other interesting videos like this. 1. To be interesting, be interested. You've heard the saying before, people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. For a long time, I always thought being interesting is trying as much as possible to say so much or force a conversation at all costs, but Dill argues otherwise. People are only interested in themselves. Therefore, they find interesting only those who are interested in them. So if you want to have influence over others, be interested in them. The biblical version of this advice is, be slow to speak, slow to anger, and quick to listen. We show we are interested in people by listening, not just hearing so we can make our own contributions, because listening is an art. It must be learned. When you show you're interested in what others have to say and how they feel or what they are going through, it's natural that they would find you interesting and would love to hear what you have to say. People often let you have your way when they've had their way. 2. Talk to someone about themselves and they'll listen for hours. I recently made a list of people I genuinely love, care about, and love to be around. Then I asked myself, why I love to be around these people? I found out the reason was simple. They always talked to me about me and always listened. If there are certain people in your life whom you do not like hanging out with, it is most likely because they don't listen to you, and they love to hear themselves talk. We all know the story of the jerk who is always interested in his own voice, story, and always wants to air his personal opinion about every matter. I have two interesting and wonderful leaders who are very close to me, but I found I could spend a few hours in the company of one and couldn't survive even an hour in the presence of the other. The reason is simple. One listens, and the other, although wonderful and caring, loves to talk so much about himself. Most people do not know how bad this is, but the psychology behind this is that people are only interested in themselves, and they will only listen to people who pay attention to them. Smart people are the ones who learn to befriend everyone. The general population only wants to be heard. Learn to listen to people and talk about them to them, and you will see you will make more friends and influence people. 3. Actions speak louder than words, and a smile says, I like you. You make me happy. I am glad to see you. There is a limit to how much your words can affect people. When I wrote that people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care, it primarily centers on not just talking to people about themselves and listening to them for hours, but proactively showing that you care through your actions. Politicians and government announce on megaphones and TV that they care. But over the years, we all have learned to take their words with a pinch of salt. History has given us examples of people who didn't just say they care, but showed it first in action. Florence Nightingale gave up her Victorian status to serve the neglected as a nurse. Mother Teresa served the relegated, marginalized, and neglected of the world. Mahatma Gandhi gave himself up for his country. Martin Luther King Jr. didn't just care for his race, he died for it. Observe something in this world. The greatest influencers are not people who make so much noise on social media or threaten people. The greatest influencers, whose significant impact never leaves the world even after they are gone, are those men and women who truly show the world they care. You want to influence people? Show them you care through your actions. 4. It isn't what you have or who you are or where you are or what you're doing that makes you happy or unhappy. It is what you think about. There is so much about thinking and how it affects our lives that one should spend so much time studying up on it till the day he dies. Listen to this. If how you think affects your life, it will be unwise to never pay attention to your thinking. In the same way, we have problems in most of our relationships because of our perspective about the other person. Most couples do not know why they keep having a fallout, but too often, each focuses on what is not good about the other. And since what we see about our partner is his or her weaknesses, you can only react negatively towards him or her. You will treat people based on how you think about them. To live a happy life, where you enjoy a good relationship with people, change the way you think. People are not your problem. It's the first thing to know. Yes, there are annoying people in the world who would try to sabotage your success. But behind that annoying outlook is a desire to be good. Somehow, if you would look deeply, you would see that people's actions are often a reaction to something. A mistreated and hurting wife who has been divorced finds it difficult to trust a man. A child who grew up in a troubled home ends up being a bully or continuously gloomy. Seeing people behind their mask will help you understand why they do what they do and will help you love them despite themselves. Change the way you think about people, and your attitude towards them will change. Then you will increase your influence over them. 5. You can't win an argument. You can't, because if you lose it, you lose it, and if you win it, you lose it. I know the story of a couple who were professors at a university. Because they were learned, none would back down for the other during an argument, and so they had an atmosphere in their home that was always tense. Soon, the woman learned that she could never win an argument by constantly fighting for it. She stopped arguing with her husband and allowed him to win. Well, this broke the man, who also began to allow the woman to win. Both ended up never arguing baselessly, but building a solid marriage relationship. Sometimes we feel it's smart to have won an argument. No, it's foolishness. Because in insisting on your right and putting the other person down, you are losing friendships and influence over people. There are people whose lives are dedicated to this kind of horrible endeavor. Such a life will make no impact on people. You do not have to resort to flattery. Neither should you allow yourself to be trampled because you want peace in the relationship. Calmly resolving a matter while letting the other person air their opinion without judging them is an excellent way to reach a win-win in an argument. A smart person will value the relationship and would want to win his friendship. A foolish person will not care if he loses the relationship and will insist upon being right. Dale Carnegie's book's premise is that you always win with people and eventually influence them when you allow them to win. It's basic human psychology. Acts of kindness provokes a reciprocal act of kindness in the other person. In the same way, acts of cruelty can provoke the same attitude in the other person. How best then should you win friends and influence people? Focus on others. Focus on their interest. Focus on what's best for others without flattering them. One of the significant rules of business success is you will get what you want if you help enough people get what they want. That's one of the reasons why great people remain great. The world never regards the man who centers his life on himself. The world regards the man who gives himself up for others. That's the trick to winning friends and influencing people. If this video inspired you, share the video with your friends. We love you.